welcome to Q&A with Prabhu Chawla. Supreme Court, in its verdict today, has raised a very important question. While delivering a judgment on the appeal filed by 17 disqualified MLAs from Karnataka, Supreme Court has ruled that they stand disqualified, which means Speaker has the power to disqualify any MLA who defects from his elected party to another party or resign even voluntarily. But it has also upheld that even the disqualified MLAs can recontest an election during the term of the same assembly to which they were elected. What does it mean? It means only one thing, that MLAs who are elected on, say, party A can defect to party B if that party fails to form the government or fails to secure a comfortable majority in the election. What happens now? According to just this judgment, which is now interpreting the power of the Speaker to disqualify the MLAs or barring the MLAs from contesting the election to come back to the same house from which they have resigned as member of the party to which they were elected. It means if any party which wins an election gets a slender majority of one or two MLAs can be reduced to minority by the other party by forcing those five or six MLAs to resign. And the party number two, which did not get the majority, becomes the party of majority and can replace a duly elected government. That is what happened in Karnataka. The BJP failed to get majority of its own. Yet, it was sworn in Karnataka by the governor. Yedurappa was made the chief minister. But he did not get the majority and he had to resign. After that, Kumaraswamy of the Janata Dal Secular was sworn in because he had the majority in the floor of the house. BJP has got only 105 MLAs out of 22 to 224 which the assembly strength is there. How did it become? Because Yedurappa later on forced 70 MLAs from JDS and Congress to resign from the House. If 17 MLAs resigned, the strength of the House came down from 224 to 207. The BJP by default became a majority party. These MLAs went to Supreme Court. Under the anti-defection law, which was passed during the regime of Rajiv Gandhi, in 1985, disqualified the MLAs who voluntarily or by force left the party on the symbol of which they were elected. Since then, many defections have taken place. Many governments have been thrown out through defection. In fact, earlier, between 1963 and 1983, according to research done by the PRS, about 2,700 people defected from one party to another. That means they were changing every month 200 elected representative lawmakers from various assemblies and parliament were shifting their loyalties on the basis of allurements or some other office. Out of those 2,700 defectors, 15 of them became chief minister of the state as well. The government was being formed, deformed, destabilized on the basis of offering ministerships or some other office bearers and duly elected governments being toppled. Rajiv Gandhi thought, okay, let me stop this concept of Ayaram Gayaram, because Gayaram was an MLA who was elected to the Haryana Assembly. He defected thrice in single day and five times in 2 weeks. But the bill was passed. From 95 onwards, defections were reduced. But now the new concept has started. Because you can't win an election, but you can topple a government. So by this latest Supreme Court judgment, it has become very easy for the party which fails to muster majority during election to convert the majority government into a minority. It has happened in the past also. In Goa, for example, BJP was number two party and Congress party was the single largest party. But within 24 hours, less than 24 hours, two-thirds MLAs of the Congress party left and merged in the Congress party. Because under the 10th schedule of the constitution, which was amended by Rajiv Gandhi and later on again amended during 2003, two-third MLAs can form another party and merge into some other party as well. So now what is happening? Because two-third MLAs is difficult to gather. If the party has 10 MLA, it is difficult to get 7 MLA to defect. So this is a new thing that you force the MLAs to quit. And if the majority is less, like in Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, the majority party, the Congress party, is ruling the state with a majority of only 5 to 6 MLAs. If BJP today decides to force the Congress IMLA, 7 or 8 or 10 of them, resign from the assemblies, Congress party, government, in both the states can fall. This judgment means that both Madhya Pradesh and Congress governments have become now vulnerable if their MLAs are open to buying and selling. That is the only time will tell. But these are two states which will suffer a threat because of the judgment which has come from the Supreme Court today after the Karnataka MLA filed their petition. The anti-defection law, which was meant to prevent defection, which was meant to ensure value-based politics or ideological-based politics, by this judgment, while the right of a person to contest an election again has been upheld, but it is served as some kind of a blow to clean politics. That is what it looks like happened. That is the answer to the question, will Supreme Court judgment stop defection or encourage defection? It may not do anything, but it will ensure that a minority party can become a majority after this judgment. Thank you very much.